Hey everyone, are you getting this error whereby your device runs into a problem and it needs to restart? So this normally happens just in case maybe you're trying to run any program on your PC, then it just crashes and gives you this error. So most times it will show you that error whereby saying kernel mode heap corruption. So I'll be showing you how to solve this. So sometimes your PC cannot even restart. Yeah, if your PC cannot restart totally, then you have to do like a factory reset, or you have to reset it to initial state. But if you can run your PC and it switches on, then I'll show you this, some of the commands you can use to bring back and to put it on the good base where it has been, like it can work well and fine like before. So this is what I'll be showing you in the video. So this is what we shall do. So these are the two commands which we shall be using. I'll leave them in the description also so that you can copy and use them. So what we shall do is we shall go ahead and click on our search bar. Then we shall search for device manager. So we shall search for device manager here. So after searching device manager, we shall go ahead to open it. Then we shall go slow. So that we don't miss out on anything. So after opening the device manager, we shall click on display adapters. So we shall go for our display adapters. This is where they are. Then we shall go ahead to click here so that we can look for our video card and select properties. So this is the display adapters. Then I'll just click on it and I'll click on properties. So after clicking on properties, I'll show you. I'll just enlighten it here a bit. The display adapters, then this one is the Intel HD graphics. So I'll click on it. Then after clicking on it, I'll go for properties. Then after clicking on properties, I'll go ahead to look for the drivers tab. So this is the tab I'm talking about. We have general, then driver details, events, resources, but we need the drivers. So we shall go here and click on it. So when you click on driver tab, you'll come and see driver details, update driver. Then we are supposed to click on roll back driver. So if this one is not highlighted like of this PC, that means we shall use another method. This is whereby we shall go ahead to use these commands. So that means we shall go ahead to use these commands as I will be showing you here. So if this driver files after updating the driver roll back to previous installed driver, so this one helps you to install back the drivers which were on the PC so that it can work well. So what we shall do, we shall go ahead to open the command prompt so that we can put in these commands. Then we go ahead to solve that issue which keeps popping up, or our PC keeps crashing and showing that error. So we shall come here to the command prompt and we shall run it as an administrator. You can go ahead to type it. If you can't find it on your search bar, then you get to run it as an administrator. I'll run it as an admin. Then I'll click yes. So here we go. This is our command prompt. So it's already opened. So I'll go ahead to use these commands as here. So you can go ahead to copy. I'll provide them in the description. You can copy this command. After copying it, then you come and paste it here. After pasting it here, you'll click on enter. Then it will do the process of scanning. So we shall wait for it to do the scanning. Meanwhile, this takes some a bit of some time.
then I won't skip any step, so it's upon you either to skip. So we shall wait for it to take a step at a time, then we see what it does exactly. So for the case of the time, I'll just be skipping somehow, because now it's just started the verification process. Here it was beginning to scan. Now this is the process of it is trying to verify. So I'll forward a bit. As you can see, it is still in 6%. So the process takes some more time. Yeah, it takes some time. You can relax a bit as you wait for it. So we are almost there for this first command we used. So the scanning is almost getting done. So as you can see, we are in 97%. So we shall wait for it to finalize up to 100%. Then I'll go ahead to copy another. I'll go ahead to copy this other one. Then I'll be pasting it there, and I'll also be showing you what next. So as you can see, the verification is complete. So now I'll go ahead to copy this second command. I'll copy this. And I'll go ahead to paste it here. So as you can see here, there is the protection found a corruption. So you can see it cannot even display it. So the details are included. So I'll not tackle that one. So I'll just go ahead to find a way of pasting this second command here. I'll just enlarge this one so that I can read for you this one well. Windows resource protection found a corrupt files and successfully repaired them. For online repairs, details are included in the CBS log file located at winrar log CBS CD. For example, you can go to your disk C, then you can check in log CBS log, then for offline repair details are included there in that file. So I won't do that one all. I'll just go ahead to copy this one. I'll just copy this one and paste it here so that I can repair this one too. If it doesn't give you options here, you can go ahead to type in another command. I'll type in another command here. If it doesn't give you an option for pasting, you can just go ahead to type it. For example, so you can just type like any one letter, then go back and copy so that you can paste it here. Then I'll remove this one. Sorry. Just clear this one so that I can paste it. Now it's okay, then I'll click on enter to go ahead. So the image servicing and management tool is gonna work on this one then. It will run everything, it will run the process in the background, then after it will give us clear results here. So this one also takes some time. Yeah, you can wait a bit. So as you can see, the process has started, it's working upon it, it's also in 6.3 like that. So we shall wait for it to finish everything, then you can see what next. So this one will have already solved the issue, so we won't get those crashes again. So this method is tested and it's working. I'll be showing you other details meanwhile as it does the process. That's why the video is a bit long, but I wanted it to take a step by step so that you can pick something from it. Meanwhile, I'll be pausing. Then when I get the clear results here, then I'll get back to you. So finally, we are done with the process, as you can see here. So everything is cleaned up. Now it is restored to health. Now it is restored and it is healthy. So these are the details and how the operation went on. The restore operation completed successful. As you can see, it is indicated here that it completed already successful, as I had shown to you. So you can now go back ahead and restart your PC if you wish, but now you're free to enjoy your PC. This is it all. Thank you guys for watching until the end of this video, though it was long, and hope you managed to get the point. Hope you managed to find the solution. So these are the two commands we use. The scan now, whereby you scan, you wait for the process to finish everything, then this command. You use this command to restore the health, then it goes ahead to do the cleaning up process of your drivers. Then here we go. Thank you for watching once again, guys. This is all of it. I'll provide all the links in the description. Kindly check them out. Thank you once again and bye.